Hello everyone! Today we're going to talk about virtual SANs, which are basically storage space elements useful to provide shared disk for virtual machines. The virtual SAN option is available under the storage menu. If we press the new virtual SAN button, we can create three types of disks. NFS is the standard Unix protocol to share files over a LAN. SMB is the common way to share files over a Windows network. iSCSI is useful to share block devices instead of files. Let's call our virtual SAN test, reserve 10 GB of space, and use the SMB protocol. A virtual SAN needs to be attached to a particular VLAN, so only virtual machines in that VLAN will be able to access it. For this example, we are going to use the test VLAN, where I have both a Windows and a Linux server. We just need to press the Create SAN button and wait a few seconds. That's it! Our vSAN is ready. Please notice that there is a column called Connection. It provides the path that must be used within the virtual machine to access this shared storage. I'm going to show how to access this virtual SAN in both Windows and Linux. In Windows, I just need to type this connection string in the Windows Explorer. And now we are not accessing the shared storage. Let's create a file just to show we can write to the folder. In Linux, we need a software called SMB Client, which also uses the same connection string. As you can see, our Linux server can see the same files and folders that were available in the Windows virtual machine, so both servers are actually sharing storage. Well, that's all. If you want to know more, please visit our documentation at www.cloud-bricks.net/docs. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.